Hello friends, this is lecture number 4 on State Pro software. In last lecture we see how we can use Cartesian coordinate system and fixed but support to model our structure. Now from beginning just double click on the State Pro icon to open it. Now today we will deal with space frame structure. Open new file, name it and define the destination folder. Fill the job information. Now today we will explore different tools of toolbar tab in detail, then learn how to define or generate load combination due to various load acting on the structure. It is live load, dead load and their combinations. Now go to geometry tab. Using snap node bin cursor, and with the help of Cartesian coordinate, we generate our frame. Shift plus N to see the node number. Then now we use beam table to add beam by node number. Shift plus E to check out the start and end point of members. Now whole structure tools to see entire structure, then zoom in, zoom out, use a view tab. Use translation lipid tool. It is used to array the elements along the global coordinate axis. This is one span shows one bay, similarly two bays and so on. Now first select the elements for translation, and it also asks what we want to translate, just member or its property also. Member property, geometry only, geometry and property only. Similarly, whether we want to link step with open base or close base. Let's do it without open base. We can see the bases are joined with beams. Undo it. Again we use translation repeat with open base. Use Shift plus E to see the node start and end points. It is here. All are aligned in the same direction. Now we will see another way to make this structure by translation. Repeat. Undo it again. As you can see, this way is faster than the last one. Now increase the frame in Y direction. See open base gates inactive. Click OK. Now convert this frame into multi-story space frame structure. That is translate in Z direction also. With base spacing 3 meter. With number of base 3. Click open base, click OK. We can rotate it left or right arrow keys on our keyboard. We can see this structure from different views using view tab from toolbar. Isometric view. Use of magnifying tool. Just select it and click it on the main screen where we want to magnify it. Again click to off it. Again undo all. Now let's see the use of mirror toolbar. Before use it, let's see how our new structure is going to differ from this structure. Again press Shift plus E to see the start and end points. Here we can see all members are aligned in same direction from the front view. From left view, now use mirror tool to model our structure. Let's see how it's going to differ from our previous structure. This mirror operation can done only for global axis or global planes. Select the plane of mirror. Right now we want YZ plane. Then move or copy, select plane. Node on plane 6, click OK. Now we can see the difference. The frame is symmetric from the middle. That is from beam 5. Similarly, generate space frame, mirror it in Z direction. First, we have to use a translate command. We can do this also by mirror command. With a mirror at the distance of 1.5 meter in Z axis. Go to top view, select the members for mirror. Select the node for mirror plane, XY plane. Node number 23. Click OK. Now see the symmetry. From left side it is symmetrical from center, from right side also it is symmetrical from center. Again do translation repeat in Y direction. This is how our same 4x2 floor structure differ from the previous one. Now the next tool, rotational translation tool, select the member to rotate. Global axis rotation is only possible. Axis of rotation, Y. Total angle, number of steps, 5. Select the node of rotation. Geometry only, or not link step, open base. This is how easily we generated pentagonal structure. Now undo it. Now again we use coordinates to rotate. Let it be minus 2, minus 5 in x direction. Click OK. सी पेंटागन बिल्डिंग। ट्रांसलेट इन बाय इट इन बाय डायरेक्शन। Now let's define its property. Let's define circular column. Use assign to view. Let's use a new tool, 3D render view tool, to see 3D view of our structure. We can see the 3D view of our Pentagon building structure. Use pan button or middle button of mouse to rotate it. Or we can also use rotational tool from the toolbar. Now, as we know, this software is based on centerline method. Let's see its joint. You can see this. Zoom previous, a new tool. Now the next tool, rotation tool. Here one question arises in our mind, how this is different from rotational tool, right? That is rotational translation tool. So answer is this. Here we can see we need to choose two nodes to define rotation axis. That is, we can rotate our structure through any local axis. Okay. Now rotate it. More copy. Save it. Link bay. Click OK. From top view, this is our primary element. Get rotated 90 degree clockwise. Here in circular translation we have global axis for rotate, while in rotation local axis coordinate can be used. Now do some local axis rotation, undo it, select the member. See how it rotates. assign a property to it. Let's see its 3D view. Now again go to initial stage. Again generate a multi-story framed structure. Translate in Y direction. Front view. Left side view. Top view. This is isometric view. Now the use of rotational tool. Rotate up. Rotate down. Rotate left. Similarly, rotate right. Spin left. Spin right. This is Tukal pin rotation. To change the point of rotation, Ctrl plus Shift plus node to rotation we have to select. Let's see. Use left or right key to rotate it. Ctrl plus Shift plus that node. Zoom in, zoom out. Display whole structure tool. Now the use of dimension tools. That is node to node this distance measurement tool. Can see 4 meter. Zoom in tool. Remove all nodes distance display. Select the member, use dimension tool, click select display, the selected beam, click display, We can see the dimensions are displayed there. To remove it, again select the dimension tool. Similarly, whole structure dimension. Now assign member property. The 3D view of our structure. Now the use of new tool, picture tool. Select the picture tool, take picture. It will capture the image of main screen. Name it and save it. At the end, we can attach it with the report file made in the post-processing mode. Again, delete the properties. Again, delete the properties. Assign new properties. Front view. Select all horizontal members in one go. Use assign to selected beam mode. Click assign. The properties assigned to all structure members. You can see its 3D view. Similarly, select all vertical members in one go. Now the next is assigning support. Add peak support. Select all nodes in one go. Click assign to selected node. the support is assigned to our structure. This is all about using different tools from the toolbar box to model the structure. Now we see how different loads, that is live load, primary load, live load and dead load are applied on our structure, as well as their combination are applied to on our structure. This will continue in our next lecture. Here we finish our lecture 4. Thank you.